Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Kicking off this episode, we'll take a look at the recent record-breaking Starlink 10 launch and other SpaceX updates. Then, as always, we'll check out Boca Chica with infrastructure and Starship updates, so let's head straight in and get up to date. So as mentioned, the first thing to talk about today is the recent launch of Starlink 10 and three SkySat satellites. This is the first time launching an orbital class rocket booster on its sixth mission.
Zero, ignition, and lift off for the Falcon 9, go Starlink.
B1049.6 then came back down from space to become the first orbital class rocket booster to land propulsively six times. On top of this, the fairing halves used on this mission were reused from a previous mission. During this Starlink 10 mission, Gomis Tree caught one of the fairing halves. However, unfortunately, Gomis Chief was unable to catch her fairing, so it made a soft water landing and was fished out. I'm also going to add some information about another launch that we could expect to see lift off this month. Previously supposed to launch all the way back in March of 2020, the SEICOM-1B satellite could lift off on Thursday, August 27th, as you can see on the SpaceXFans website. According to a tweet from space reporter Michael Sheets, SpaceX sought just over $2 billion in funding and managed to obtain just over $1.9 billion instead. There was a tweet from Michael Baylor reiterating what ULA said, which is reusability will only make sense after 10 flights. Musk responded and gave some information on the economics of reusing boosters by saying payload reduction due to reusability of booster and fairing is less than 40% for Falcon 9 and recovery and refurb is less than 10%, so you're roughly even with two flights, definitely ahead with three. So other than those updates, there's no other standard SpaceX updates to cover, so over to Boca Chica. To begin these updates, we'll start over by the Super Heavy launch pad construction. They've recently added a tube down the middle and some bars to hold up the rebar structures. Some people were thinking it could be a water tower, but as Jack Beyer has pointed out, it's not a water tower. Whilst only speculative and based on what we've seen recently, here is a great diagram of how the mount could end up looking. The test mount that has been sitting outside for months is now on the move. It was moved to the lower pad where the first SN7 tank recently was. I'm sure the plan is to use it for SN7.1 testing, but the question is whether they will continue to use it. I sort of want to think they might install ground support equipment and pipes to be able to test multiple Starship prototypes at once. Moving on and over to the construction yard, an interesting addition to the mid-bay has been spotted. They've added some cool LED lights, and whilst I doubt it helps with Starship development, it looks great. I want to assume it's maybe to prepare for the Starship presentation next month. Also, over in the production area, the high bay is still progressing at pace as they continue with the fourth level. I suggested maybe this was the final level of the high bay last episode, but others suggested otherwise. So it's possible that the reason these panels are smaller in height could be because of wind. Moving on to some Starship and Raptor information, we have a series of tweets from Elon Musk. First of all, Musk tweeted these pictures of Raptor and Raptor data along with the caption of Raptor engine just reached 330 bar chamber pressure without exploding. Further Raptor information was released by Musk on Twitter in response to a tweet from Chris Burgin. Elon Musk responded to say SN40 is about to be tested and has several upgrades over 330 bar engine. For reference, 330 bar on Raptor produces approximately 225 tons or 500,000 pounds of force. So SpaceX are already on Raptor SN40, that's insane, but they are going to need a heck of a lot more of these engines. Somebody recently tweeted a video with a great rendering of Starship performing a 20 kilometer flight. During the video, Starship was reoriented using its RCS thrusters, so Musk corrected it. He said, "Very impressive render. Note, legs will be bigger and there'll be way more stuff in the engine bay. Main engines actually do majority of work in turning ship vertical before landing." Further to this, Everyday Astronaut tweeted about Merlin and Raptor's abilities to throttle down. Musk's response was, max demonstrated Raptor thrust is approximately 225 tons and minimum is approximately 90 tons, so they are actually quite similar. Both Merlin and Raptor could throttle way lower with added design complexity. Raptor pre-burner and Merlin gas generator flame out at what limit lower bound? So with those Starship and Raptor updates covered, let's actually take a look at some Starship pieces. First up, there's a new three-ring stack that was spotted outside, although the intended Starship is currently unknown. Spotted arriving recently were a whole load of new Starship components. Somebody asked me last episode where these are produced, and I may be wrong, but I'm pretty sure they are manufactured in Hawthorne. However, here you can see more of those new version 1.1 legs. There were also some other components on the trailer that were covered in tarp. When the cover was removed, we got to see even more components with a downcomer and thrust puck. Given that we've seen a bunch of these recently, I want to guess that these new pieces are possibly for SN9. As well, another Starship piece being worked on is that other three ring stack we saw last episode with cutouts. Looks like they are cutting this barrel section further and doesn't look like something we've seen before. So again, I'm going to say this could have just been for testing and maybe destined for the scrap pile. With those Starship updates covered, let's take a look at the main Starship news with the testing of SN6. Prior to testing, engineers were adding the final touches before the cryogenic proof test. Some interesting footage that was captured has some audio which I presume is coming from Starhopper.
Attention on the pad, Starship is powering on for the operation. Starship is powering on for the operation today.
Then, on Sunday, August 16th, the pad was cleared and the road was closed. Throughout the day, the company did some ambient and cryogenic proof testing. This is the first step in the process of making sure this vehicle can sustain the pressure and fuel. Definitely don't want to see another failure. Thanks to La Padre for allowing me to use this footage. With that important step in the testing process complete, engineers then began working to remove the thrust simulator. With that, engineers are going to begin to look at installing the Raptor engine that SN6 will fly with. As it turns out, we already know which Raptor serial number will be assisting SN6 with its testing. Here we have Raptor SN29 as it heads to the launch area to be installed to the underside of Starship SN6. Engineers were also spotted lifting the engine up inside the test mount to position it for SN6 installation. As you will find out in just a moment, they are going to be getting the engine and tank ready at a rapid pace. We have some dates in which to expect testing as the FAA has posted a new notice to airmen. The FAA document places a temporary flight restriction for August 19th until September 2nd. Not only does the TFR give us some information about when testing will happen, but also we have some road and beach closures. With a primary testing date of August 24th and backups of 25th and 26th, we should expect to see a static fire on Monday. As always, an enormous thank you goes to Mary, more commonly known as Boca Chica Girl, for going out in the blazing Texas heat to film this awesome footage. Also, a huge thank you to the NASA spaceflight team for all their work and dedication. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.